six guys with not a whole lot going on except some music, and you keep practicing, you get the word out, play as many gigs as you can, and put out your own little independent record just to make sure that you've got something to say, and people respond. They like the music, they like the tunes, they like to come see us.
Come up to you and say, Jack.
Yeah, everybody thinks my name is Jack now.
So where does jacksoul come from?
It just meant new music to me. I just thought it was a great little new twist on a couple of old syllables, you know, soul from back in the days. We used to have like James Brown, Gotta Have Soul. And we had Sam and Dave, you know, I'm a soul man. And then by the 80s, it became, you know, it wasn't so much about soul or vibe or lots of emotion. It was more about production. And Chuck D kept screaming about, you know, who stole the soul. So I thought when it was like the mid-90s and I was getting the band off the ground, it's a great way of sort of teething back all that great vibe that nobody feels like putting into the music anymore. So jacksoul just sort of stands for that return to, you know, music kind of thing. In the States, you know, you have a very specific sound. It's you know, mainstream R&B is a particular thing. It's got nothing to do with funk. It's got nothing to do with you know, gospel. It is its own thing, and I think it's because it's very uncut. You live in the inner city down south, and it is just you and your people, and that's really that's all you have. That's your whole essence, your whole experience. Here is this amorphous animal that just takes tasty bits from all sorts of different types of pop styles and brings it together on top of a fatter beat and a sweet groove. It's sort of like, the best way to explain it is Deborah Cox.
Yeah.
She's a straight up mainstream R&B artist. That kind of animal can't sustain itself up here because, you know, as a world-class diva, she can't find other people to collaborate with to get that mainstream, straight-up R&B sound. She has to go someplace else.
When you finished this album, why did you decide to run with a single? Because the single is blowing up everywhere.
I think it sort of represented for me a nice way to kick off, you know, high energy, just sort of hit you over the head and catch your attention really quickly. I had no idea that it would catch on as well as it has, so we feel pretty blessed. But as well, it's just a different enough twist than what we've been doing. We always had the cool vibe and, you know, tasty bass lines and things, but this was very in your face and very over the top, and I thought, okay, this will catch everybody's attention. For the people that were already jacksoul fans, it'll be, you know, a nice little twist of flavor. Still based on the same old school kind of, you know, underpinnings. There's even a little Motown in there.
Yeah.
But for people that had never even heard of jacksoul, it might be just a good wake up for them. My stuff has always sort of come from, you know, a little bit of this place and that place, because I'm always into so many different styles. I was never really mainstream. Mm-hmm. In that way, it makes total sense that I'd, you know, find this place home and be able to create here and come up with an alternative R&B sound, I guess is what the guys in the States are calling it.
Yeah.